Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Stranded Deep, where we are currently still stranded and still deep. Well, maybe not so deep, but we are definitely stranded and lost, and we're on this big island here. I had to do something off camera, which I apologize for. I try not to to do that generally. Well, sometimes I do. But in this case and in this series, I haven't really done anything off camera. But when I last left off, I wanted to be able to close down the game and save the game so that I could go do other stuff. So I had to set up a shelter on this big island in the middle of nowhere so that I could save. But I haven't slept or anything. Look, the vitals are still the same. Inventory and everything is still the same. All I did was chop down a palm tree, got the leaves and the sticks, and three coconuts as well, which was great. So we'll probably eat those or drink from them anyway. And sleep here as well. Actually, we might save sleeping for tonight because we've got day, right? We need to go out and do some more exploring. Well, we got to find our way back to the goddamn island as well now that it's day. Because exploring and traveling around at night is a real pain in the ballsack, isn't it? I think we're going to have to ditch that one altogether. We're going to see if we can get away with not doing anything at night except for sleeping. So that we can just, like, blast through the night. Did we get that? Yeah, we did. Okay, great. We're going to get three of these things. We're going to drink them up. I mean, we could go get some fruit and survive. But we seem to be doing okay at surviving. So a couple of people have been saying that I'm missing out on a large portion of the game by not exploring these, like, underwater wrecks. I don't have any scuba gear or anything. But I guess the idea is to just get your boat, like, up close to them, jump in, have a whale of a time down there and get some cool stuff and come back up and avoid the sharks and stuff. So we're going to try that today so we can potentially get more bits and pieces that we need for the engine, for the motorboat. Because that's the dream, right? The Rio dream. Motorboating all over the goddamn world. That's what I'm talking about. Did we? That's the empty one. All right, let's chuck that one down on the ground. Okay, that's delicious. That's also delicious, and holy crap, that is really delicious. Okay, great. Three delicious sips of coconut juice, and we are, like, fully hydrated now. All right, let's bash this one up and eat it, because we might as well. And we won't bash the other two up, because we'll hang on to them and probably fill them up with water and maybe drink them later. All right, we seem to be in good shape here. Perfect. Charlene is ready to go. We have this makeshift shelter here, should we ever need it again, but I don't think we'll need it again. And we're going to have to try to find our home base, which another thing I should probably mention. My theory on how compasses work turns out to not be a thing. I mean, at the same time... I have no excuse, actually. I should probably know how a compass works. I've just never really looked into it. And you know what? I don't really fucking care either. I mean, I would never need to use a compass in real life. And you know what? If I was stranded in real life and my life depended on it, you know what? I would rather die than learn how a compass works. I really just don't give a shit. There's a lot of things in this world that I don't give a shit about. And you know what? Up there, I would say, is definitely... Oh, hang on a second. Compasses. I just don't give a shit about a compass or how they work. And the main reason is because, actually, I didn't know how they work. And I took a guess at how they work. And I was totally wrong about how they work. And now I'm kind of angry about that. So I'm feeling, like, overly hostile towards a compass. I mean, I gotta say, at the same time, that's not very nice. It's not a very nice thing to say about compasses or to compasses. But that's... that's the way the cookie crumbles sometimes. So if you are out there and you're watching this and you are a compass or you identify as a compass and you're offended by the things that I've just said, I'm really sorry. I am truly sorry, but at the same time, you know, maybe go do one somewhere. Because, you know, at the same time, I couldn't figure out how you work. And, well, I have no regrets about that whatsoever. Is this our island? No, it can't be. Can it? There's an island over there. We're just going to island hop. I mean, how many islands are out here? I'd say that there's about 12. So we're bound to come across our island at some point. I mean, at the very least, look, there's like a wreck out here, a sunken wreck, which maybe we haven't looted yet, so we could maybe check that out. It looks like there's like a little box floating on the water, but that will soon turn into like a gigantic ship. Just because of the way the pop works in this game. It's not terrible, I would say. It's not the best either, but I mean, it's an early access game, right? So there's like still like lots of stuff coming and optimizations to be made and shit like that. Have we? No, I don't think we have, you know. Like, the door's not open or anything. So this could well be something worth investigating. Let's open the door. Make sure there's no sharks inside there. That's always, like, a good thing to do. All right, well, we're going to hop off the raft now and hope that we don't get eaten by a shark or killed out here whilst we explore a jerry can that we don't need. There's a bucket there, a hammer, and what's the binoculars? Okay, so we have all of that stuff already. There's some more buoyoys here as well if we want them. I mean, we could take them back to our island and add them to the collection. We have a whole bunch of buoy balls, which is quite nice. Do we want to get down here and take a look around? Probably not. I don't think there's going to be anything under the boat. Huh. It's actually kind of liberating getting under here. Swimming around. It's pretty good. Okay. We can get right back onto Charlene, no problem. So that's something that we're going to do, right? We have no way of marking stuff because we can't take a dump on the beach and we can't take a dump on the boat. Oh, shit. You know what? Old Eagle Eyes Malone here almost left without checking this box on the roof. Luckily, these guys always keep a box on the roof. Am I right? I don't know why they do, but look, there's an air tank here. Haha! All right, we might be able to make some scuba gear after all. Holy crap. Okay, I mean, I don't want to hold the air tank in case, like, something happens. So let's just do this. We'll get onto the... There we go. We are on the ship. Man, this game is really good, isn't it? It's really a lot of fun. I mean, it's fun to get out here and survive. It's fun to explore the wrecks and stuff. It's not so fun to bump into sharks. But, I mean, let's face it. It's never going to be fun bumping into sharks. Even if you're in Marine World and you're looking at, like, one of those glass-bottom tank things that you can walk around and so that you and your kids and your mom and your dad and your grandparents, all as a family, generations and generations of the same family can stand underground, look through glass at the wonders and the marvels of nature in the safety, the confines of like a controlled environment. It's a controlled corporate environment as well. So, I mean, they're really going to try to limit their liability in a major way. So there's probably, I would say, like a 0% chance of that tank cracking open, sharks spilling out, and then enslaving you, or even worse, like eating you and dismembering you in front of like generations of your family or whatever. And I think that that's probably the safest way to view sharks. But at the same time, don't be such a pussy. Get out there in like one of those cages, you know, like you can go to South Africa where there's tons of it was like the great whites like lived down around there, the great white sharks, in like some sort of, I don't know, crazy ass reef or whatever. And you can go out there on a boat. It's like a guided tour or whatever. You get down there. You can see the sharks. You can go into one of those cages and you can put on one of those, you know, gloves or whatever. It's like a, I think it's like a chainmail glove or something. And you smother yourself in like dead fish so that, you know, it attracts them because that they can't see or whatever. So they'll make their way towards you when they sense those dead fish. They come over and they, you know, it's like, I don't know why people have a fascination with doing that, you know, putting like on a glove or whatever and having something try to like rip your arm off, but they can't like chew through it or whatever. Because people do that with dogs all the time too, right? Like you see it time and time again, like, you know, like people that train dogs, like police trainers and stuff like that, when they're training like the attack dogs or like the sniffer dogs or whatever. Oh, here, look, there's another wreck here. Our inventory is like super full though. We might have to have a makeshift base if I can't find the old base. Because we are collecting multitudes of crap right now. You know what? I don't think there's going to be anything on that one. Like, that one's really had it. But yeah, I don't get it. I don't get why you would want to do that. I don't know why you'd want to make a dog so angry that it's like trying to pull your arm off in the first place. Because they do, right? They like, they have all these tricks to like anger the dogs. Like, they use like a whistle. And they, I don't know, insult them and stuff. And the dogs just go crazy and they try to bite their arms off. But, like, what do you get from it? Are you just trying to test, like, to make sure that your glove is resilient enough to, like, not let the teeth through or something, or what? Like, same with sharks. Like, do you really feel the need to have a shark bite your arm and survive to... Fuck me. Shit! This fucking island again? How? What the hell? Jesus! My fucking sense of direction and navigation is terrible. Oh my god. Okay, I'm sitting there wondering what island it is. It's literally the one I just came from. Jeez. All right, we're gonna head this way instead. This is definitely an island we have not been to in a while anyway. If you remember, actually, this is the island that we were at the first time that we played and I died. This is the one, I think, that had like all the scrap and everything. And I don't know if you remember, I tried to take the scrap back on the life raft. It didn't quite work and it fell off. I tried with the tires too. And then we sort of died on that island all by ourselves, and it was really sad. But I think I know how to get back to our other island from here, if this is indeed the right one. It could just be another one. So I won't promise anything, but we'll see. Anyway, back to talking about sharks and dogs biting your arm and not hurting you. I think the TLDR for that one is, what the fuck? I don't get it. Is it like a thrill thing or something? Or is it just like, I don't know, some sort of way of, holy shit. Hang on. We've definitely seen to these two boats though, right? Like, I'm pretty sure. Although, I don't know if we would have actually been on that one. Because I don't think that we had a way up. Or at least I didn't realize that you could use these fucking bars. The really fancy looking bars, like on the side. Or did I figure this out already? Let's try it out anyway. Alright, here we go. We're on. Climbed up. We're gonna take a look. Alright. It doesn't look like this boat is gonna see any action anytime soon. Certainly, nobody's tushy anyway, because I don't know anyone in their right mind that would ever sit on that. Like, it looks horrible. It's probably gonna cut your butt up and everything. Alright, look. We haven't been down here. There's another jerry can that we don't need. What else is there? Is there anything back here? Yes, of course. There's like a little box back here. It's got nothing in it. It looks like they were transporting some sort of priceless artifact, which has now been lost and forgotten. And you know what? I don't think anyone cares about it anymore. Now that it's down here, just like collecting dust and rust. The fuck? How? Oh, maybe I'm using the knife, and when actually I should be using the hammer or something on these. How do I get these barrel bits? Like, I really want this hobo stove. Okay, the knife didn't work. The hammer didn't work. Maybe this big old hammer? No? No. It's like opening it or something. I don't know what it's doing. Or is it... What the fuck? Maybe these barrels, you just can't do shit with them. Maybe we can hammer this console. Why is this console down here? Oh, I see. I think it's something to do with the... And now I can't, like, fucking... Okay, well, my inventory doesn't work now. Okay, let's just get the fuck out of here. Maybe I can, like... What the hell? I don't know what happened. All right. Can I interact with... No, I can't. I can't do shit. I've broken the game somehow. Is it something to do with, like... Maybe I have to jump in the water or something? Like, I can't do shit right now. Oh, this is terrible. I'm gonna be stuck forever on this boat. I can't swing my hammer. I can't open anything. I can't do anything. I'm clicking furiously. Maybe I just have to do like a double or a triple jump? No? What the hell? I can't figure it out. Look, I can't do shit. This is crazy. Oh no. I don't want to have to like close the game down or anything. Maybe if I just violently mash my mouse button. I don't know if you can hear that clicking in the back, but I am really going for it. Maybe, can I do anything with the barrels now? No, I can't. I think these barrels are like linked up to this console somehow. Like, I think when I'm hitting the barrels, it's actually opening and closing the console behind me. That's what I think anyway. That's the theory. What the hell? Maybe if I just like, ah, there we go. Okay, I should have done that the whole time. Alright, let's get out of here before the whole game breaks and I start to cry. Is there anything else worth exploring on here? No. I don't think there was anything worth exploring in the first place. God, it's such a piece of shit. It's gonna get dark soon too, so we're gonna either want to go back to where we were before and use that shelter to sleep. Because actually, well, you know what? We should probably do that. Because I think we're gonna die of sleep deprivation at this rate. Like, we really need to sleep. And also, I don't want to be out here exploring in the fucking dark. Jeez, this... Charlene, please! Please comply! Jeez! Okay, so we came in from this way, right? So we're going to head back out this way to this island. That's the island that we were at. We're going to head back there, and we're going to sleep. And we might even eat some bits of coconut if we need to. I think we're okay for hydration and stuff. I think it's really just sleep that we need. We can even do like a double sleep just to like blast through the night. I think you can do that. I think you can double sleep and it blasts through the whole night. And then we won't be out here in the dark with our pants down during like feeding time for the sharks or whatever. Even though I think feeding time is all the time for sharks, realistically. Well, as far as I know anyway. Holy shit. There's a real freeze and a lot of pop there. All right. So, if I'm right, and I think I am right, our shelter should be straight ahead. Well, kind of straight ahead, if we can make it. It's really wavy out here. Maybe there's like a storm coming in or something. I don't know, but we'll see. Well, or we won't, actually, because I don't think there are actual storms in the game. But I think it's like I was saying before, I think it's like simulated or something. So, you know, you still get like rainwater and stuff as if there was a storm, but you just don't see the storm and you can't hear any wind or anything like that. Like, maybe that's just like something that's coming soon. I don't know. Actually, in saying that, I have no idea what the dev roadmap is for this game at all. Like, I haven't even looked. I don't know, like, if they're on course with the stuff that they're hoping to develop or what. Oh, hang on. Here we are. We almost overshot. All right, Charlene, we're going to beat you. We're going to beat you right here. Like a whale. We're going to drag you up onto the beach as well so that you can't escape from us. You're not getting away that easy, Charlene. And we are going to sleep in... Where the hell is it? Here it is. All right, perfect. Let's have a sleep. We drift off into the hazy blue darkness of Sleepland. You know what? Oh, you can't... Yes? We're going to do it again. We can't sleep again so soon, apparently. So what the hell time is it? Okay, it's 3:55 in the morning. That's not too bad. All right, are we hungry? A little bit. We're really thirsty, so we can go around looking for fruit until day breaks or whatever. Let's crack open one of these. We might as well. I don't think they spoil when they're like this, so that's good. Boom. Bong. Great. Perfect. Should we take some antibiotics? No, I don't think we should. Okay. We'll put this bucket down here. We'll pick these things up and eat them. Oh, yeah, delicious. Perfect. And you know what? Actually, I'm going to leave this bucket here because with my flashlight on, we're going to go out, we're going to hunt around for fruit, and we're going to eat up all the fruit on this island. This island is going to be rich in fruits. Okay. I can feel it. Look, there's a couple of... No, that's not... That's a tree. It's not like a fruit tree. We're looking for like the little bushes that have the fruits in them. There's some yucca. We don't really need any yucca right now. There's some more yucca that we don't need. There's a whole bunch of ficus here. Don't really need that either. I mean, if we were chopping and looking to make a shelter or something, I would say yeah, we would definitely need that. But we don't right now. What the fuck? Where are all the fucking fruit trees on this island? Jeez. Seriously, there's not a single one? Oh, I think I see one. Okay, we'll head over there. That's not a fruit tree. I don't even know what that is, actually. It's got huge leaves, though. Is this one? Oh, this is one. Oh, yeah, there's a fruit as well. One fruit. We've done it. We did it, everybody. One fruit acquired. We probably realistically need to eat about 10 of those. What the fuck? Oh, I thought that was a coconut half. It's like, who the hell else is out here eating coconuts, leaving a trail of destruction behind? Should only be me out here leaving a trail of destruction behind. More fruit. That's right. And by trail of destruction, of course, I mean just like a long, slippery path of diarrhea behind me because my entire diet right now is fruits. Like, we haven't eaten a crab or anything for a long-ass time. And that's because surviving is... not that difficult in this game, but if you want to truly survive and live like a king out here, you really have to get your shit set up. And of course, I don't have my shit set up. I do have that huge water thing now, though, but I can't find the island to get back and use it, which kind of sucks, actually. But there you go. All right, how did we do? We did good. Holy shit, our vitals are like perfect. We're gonna head back to Charlene because it's almost daybreak. Is it? Yes, it is. Okay, the sun should be rising any minute now. Look at that, the moon. We're heading straight to the moon. It looks like the moon has like its own little moon in front of it right now. Or the moon has a nipple. However you want to look at it, it's fine. Okay, so we came in from that way. So I think that our island is possibly that way. We're going to test this out and see. We're going to hopefully not upend Charlene as well, because I dragged her from like the wrong spot. Charlene, please. Please. You're giving me nothing but grief for some reason, all of a sudden. What did I do to you? Is it because we're going to be replacing you soon with the Rio-mobile? I don't think you should feel bad about that. You know, your time, you're going to have your time, Charlene. You're going to have your time in the sun. You've taken us to many places. We've done many things together. But all good things must come to an end, Charlene. And when we get replaced by Rio, don't worry. We'll have a party for you and everything. It'll be fantastic. You'll love every minute. Wait. Is that just coral, or is that a little wreck that I didn't see before? No, it's just coral. Coral, of course, that we're about to ram into because Charlene... Well, no. Okay, fine. I won't say it's Charlene because, you know what? You didn't ram us into that, and it was fine. All right, we're heading this way. That looks like a big island out there. We may actually be on our way home right now, if you can believe that, with full vitals as well. It's been a long and tedious exploration romp that we've been on, but there you go. Apparently that line of buoyoyoys that I found the other day, which I thought was breaking my immersion and was like the edge of the map or whatever, isn't. It's just like an indicator that you're going into really, really deep water. I don't know what you can do in really, really deep water, but I'm assuming that maybe we can go on some diving excursions, because I do have an air tank. I think if I can find like a mask and maybe some tubes, or maybe I can make some tubes myself with like some bamboo or something. Is there bamboo out here? Possibly. We may never know. Is that a fucking whale? Holy shit. Oh my god. Look at the fucking size of it. Jeez. Wow. We did it. Wow. Look at it go. I mean, it must just be thinking, what the fuck is this lunatic doing? He's on a little ass ramp. He's coming close to me. I'm a gigantic whale just like basking in the sea. Oh man, that is fucking awesome. Look at it. Does it dive down and stuff? Is it safe to get out and look at him from underneath? See if he's smiling? Because he might be. Oh man, imagine we went down there and he was just smiling like, hey, how are you? It's so lonely out here. Oh, I love running into people, especially crazy people that name their ship and talk to their ship because they have no one else to talk to. I like that. I really like that a lot. Fuck me, that is so cool. Holy shit. I wish I had my flare gun, because then we could give him like a fireworks party as well. Anyway, I'm too scared to, you know what? Fuck it. Carpe diem. You know what I'm saying? We're going for it. What's up, whale? Oh, shit. Is it ever fucking crazy under here? All right. Where is it? We just got to hit the surface. It's right here. We can't really see the whale. We're close to the whale. Whoa! He's huge! Look at the size of this thing! Holy shit! He's not smiling. He's frowning a bit. Man, it's a humpback whale. I know that, because all I had to do was get close to it, and he highlighted in yellow, and it said humpback whale. Holy shit. He was frowning a little bit, it's gotta be said. But, at the same time, maybe he values his privacy, and here I am getting all up in his personal space, invading his aura. Alright, Mr. Humpback Whale, peace out. Man, that was exciting. Holy shit. And you know what? There's more good news, everybody, because guess what? This is definitely our island. If this is not our island, I will, oh god, is there any mechanic in this game to eat a shoe or, like, I don't know, like, eat your own ball sack or something? Because I would totally do either of those. I got a feeling that maybe this isn't our island, so it's a good thing I didn't actually commit to either of those things. I don't want to eat a shoe, and I certainly do not want to eat my own ball sack either. And it's just as well, because I think we're still lost, but you know what? At least we're not at that other crappy island that I went back to like 20 times. You know what? I say it's crappy. It wasn't that crappy. It had a lot of fruit on it. And we ate all of that fruit, and man, was it good. And our vitals are, like, great now as a result, too. So we're just going to have to cruise in here, even though this isn't our island, and keep our peckers up. Because, you know what? We will eventually find our island. It's just a matter of time. We just have to keep trying. And you know what? If we bump into some more humpback whales along the way, and we can get off our raft and get in there and swim after them and tell them jokes and keep them company for a bit, even though I'm sure they don't value my company whatsoever, well, that'll be nice. And it'll be a good way to break up the monotony of trying to find our way back home. You know what this feels like? It feels like that Star Trek movie, you know, when they couldn't find their way back home. Spock was getting, like, super duper homesick, and everybody was getting annoyed with Spock as well, because he just kept fucking waffling on all the time about how great Vulcan was, and he missed it. He was just, like, boring everybody with, like, all their customs and, like, all this other shit. And by the end of it, when they finally did get home, they were like, thank fucking God. And then they banned Spock from ever coming back on board the Enterprise for at least a couple of years while they all got over it. They moved on a bit, you know. Kirk went off and, like, did some farming and stuff. And I think Bones, like, went and helped them a bit. And just shit, general shit like that. And then I think over the course of, like, 3 or 4 years, they got to the point where it was like, you know what? Actually, I don't hold any ill will towards Spock anymore. Even though at the time when we couldn't find our way back home and he was talking about Vulcan too much, man, I fucking hated him. And I wanted to strangle him with my bare hands right in front of everybody on the bridge of the Enterprise. But you know what? Those days are gone now. And I don't feel so bad anymore. Oh, shit. That looks promising. Oh, man, does that ever look promising. All right, we're heading straight for that island. And Jesus Christ, I don't know what I'll do if it's that other one, but at least there's a shelter on that one, and that maybe we can have, like, another sleep or whatever. Let's check our vitals if we can. We can just have, like, a quick peek at them if we're lucky, if we hit a nice wave. Oh, yeah, it looks like we're good. We're just missing a little bit of sleep, and we're missing a little bit of H2O, or, well, hydration. So we should be able to survive. If I see a container just slowly pop in, I might actually cry tears of joy, because it would really be nice to get back to our gigantic trash mound. And you know what? That water collector must be just fucking full to the brim by now, I would say as well. I don't know if this island's big enough to be our island, though. Like, our island was pretty big, and it had a lot of palm trees on it as well. This one has a few palm trees, but not as many as I grew accustomed to. Is this the one that we started on? Which means that that one in the distance might be it. Oh, fuck, we have to check. Man, I'm still reeling after that whale encounter. Man, that was great. Holy shit. More of that, please, game. If you're listening to me somehow. Oh, shit. Is this? Oh, no, I think it's just like a bunch of coral. Man, how fucking scary was that jumping off the raft in the middle of the sea, too? Like, you feel really, really exposed when you're out there, don't you? Like, there's just nothing. Oh, shit, there is a wreck here, but I think it's an old-ass wreck with maybe nothing to offer us except for possibly a little bit of welcome adventure. Adventure? I mean, it doesn't look like there's any. There could be some boxes down there, though. Am I brave enough? Oh, you know what? Fuck it. You know what I said before we jumped off and went to see the whale? It was like some Latin or something, and I can't remember how to pronounce it. I don't even think I pronounced it right the first time, so there's that. There's a box. It's a toolbox. Oh, there's a duct tape. Well, great. We have two duct tapes now. Why not? Maybe we can patch up Charlene with this duct tape. Was that worth it? I don't know if it was, but you know what? Fuck it, I'll take it. Why not? More duct tape. Could never hurt. I mean, I'm a dad. I've got a garage. I've got a tool shed and everything. Do I have one roll of duct tape? Hell no. I have like 20. Because you never know when you're going to need that stuff. Like, it's really good. It's really fucking sticky, too. And it's really good for, like... It's kind of weird because you'd think it would just be used to, like, stick things together or, like, patch things up or whatever. And while that's true, it actually has other uses as well because it's so sticky. Here's a good trick for you, okay? If you ever find yourself in a situation where you have to change a halogen bulb, you know those halogen, like, the ceiling lights? And they're, like, inside those little receptacle things? And it's really tight between like the light and like the edge of the receptacle, so you couldn't really get your fingers in there to screw it off or whatever. A nice little trick is you roll up a piece of duct tape because it's like super fucking sticky, and then you stick it to the front of the bulb, and then you just pull the bulb out instead of having to use your fingers to like get in there and unscrew it as well. I mean, that only works for the ones that you can pull straight out. If you have to twist them or whatever, you could probably still use the tape, but it might be a little bit tricky. But I'm just saying, like, that's a pretty good trick, right? I mean, I had to do that this weekend. That's why it's on my mind. So there. All right. Well, anyway, look, we're going to make a landing here. We're going to land here. We're going to just pick all of the fruit that we can from this island, even though we don't really need to. I'll make a quick shelter here and stuff. I'll sleep and everything. Or, well, I probably won't sleep. I'll at least make a shelter and save while I'm here. Oh, look. There's a wreck out there that we'll explore and stuff. We'll do all that next time. And hopefully, we're sort of on the right path to get back home. And when we do find home again, we'll never leave that island ever again. Because, man, we've gotten so horribly fucking lost out here. It's crazy. But we're still surviving. And we saw a whale. And there's still other stuff to explore. And I got an air tank as well. So we can't be that far from getting, like, scuba gear, right? Here we go. That's what I'm talking about. Fucking, there's another one here, too. Holy shit. All right. As usual, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time!